Look at that. 2011 versus last year. California is the seventh largest economy in the world, not because of Silicon Valley or Hollywood, but because of agriculture. Virtually all of the almonds, artichokes, lemons, pistachios, and processed tomatoes grown in the U.S. come from that state's Central Valley. Let me bring in Jay Famiglietti. He's a senior water scientist at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, also professor of earth science at UC Irvine. Thank you for being here. You've written a lot about this, most recently an op-ed in the LA Times. It got a lot of attention. You call water the new oil. That's how important this situation, how dire it is in California right now.
That's right. It is pretty bad. We, over the last few years, have lost something like 12 million acre feet of water per year for the last 3 or 4 years. That's more water than all Californians, all 38 million Californians use every year. So it's a tremendous amount of water. A lot of it, about two-thirds of it, is from groundwater depletion, and the groundwater is used to support agriculture. So we're really in a very, very difficult situation.
So what can you do? Because what the farmers are doing there, because they have to provide for their crops, is that they're drilling up all of this groundwater. And up until very recently, there was nothing to regulate how much they could take, and it's harder to, you know, it gets depleted at some point.
That's right.
I guess
right.
What I'm asking is, what can be done to stem this?
Well, we did in California pass new legislation, thankfully, and you know, what an upside of the drought is that we're able to get this passed. And that legislation hopefully will help slow the flow. But one of the issues is that it's going to take a few, you know, water legislation is complicated. It's going to take a few decades for that new legislation to be implemented. And so my private fear is that we may run out of groundwater in some places before the legislation has a chance to kick in.
Can you paint the picture for everyone watching of what that scenario would look like and how the average person would feel it?
Well, I think the future of California is one that is not quite apocalyptic, but we'll have some major changes. We'll still have agriculture, I think, but we'll be planting different things that are more efficient. I think the message is we'll have to evolve towards more efficiency. Maybe we'll be growing less food. Maybe we'll be growing different crops. The bigger issue, I think, is that most of us in California will have to realize that we actually live in an arid or semi-arid environment, and we will have to get by with much less water.
Jay Famiglietti, thank you so much. You've done extensive work on this. We appreciate you coming on the program. Good to have you.
My pleasure. Thanks a lot.